Hi there, Osi.
Hi. Yeah.
Hi there. Can you introduce yourself to the people that are listening?
Hi, I'm Osi from Nigeria, living in Brighton at the moment. Hi.
Okay. And you contacted me with a question about atheists, and I invited you to do this call. And
Yes.
I always invite people and invite them to do two calls, one where I set the topic and one where my opponent sets, or opponent, but the other one sets the topic. This time the topic is what do you believe and why? And as you explain, I will ask you questions about what you tell us. Is that okay?
Oh, okay. Fair.
Yeah?
Fair enough, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So please go ahead and tell me what you believe and why you believe it.
Okay, I believe that this world did not just happen by chance. Like, there's a grand master design, master planner behind everything. Because if you look closely, everything is like perfect. Humans, we have two arms, two legs, two eyes. Like, it's just perfectly planned. Like, you know, something really happened. Like it wasn't just like a big bang, an explosion or something that created the whole universe. 'Cause I know who created the God in heaven, Jehovah Jireh, created the whole wide world.
Okay,
That's what I believe in.
can I ask you why you would say you know it?
Okay, it's just I just know like it's a strong. Like nothing can like, I don't know how to explain it, 'cause it's obvious. Like, okay, no one recorded this. It doesn't seem natural. It doesn't seem real. But I just know, like, I just know it. Yeah, no explanation for my knowing it.
Okay, but if that would be your reason, then
Okay, wait. Do
where do
you
you
mean
get where do
my?
you get from the reason you just gave to the Christ
Oh,
to the
okay.
Christian God?
Oh, okay. This is it. 'Cause wait, do you mean my reason for like believing in God?
Yeah, you just said it couldn't all come about without a God, but that wouldn't explain which God. So what I'm
Okay, yeah,
interested
you're
in is why would that automatic for you at least automatically mean it's the Christian God?
okay, I don't actually mean. Okay, 'cause yeah, there's a reason for this, 'cause I re read it in the Bible, the Word of God, and like everything from there is true. Like God doesn't lie, and He said He created it, and therefore I believe Him.
But you do know that a lot of things in the Bible have been disproven. And that doesn't worry you?
Like what?
Like, let's start at the beginning. The sequence of creation didn't happen that way, and we know that today. Adam and Eve.
How do you know that?
Because at least logically doesn't make sense that there would be plants before there would be light, and through biology we know how plants got
No, you are wrong. I think you mixed it up, because in the beginning he said let there be light, because the whole world was in darkness. So light was one of the first things he created before he created the trees and the plants.
yes, but he didn't create the sun,
He did.
but not on the first
That
day.
is the light.
No, not on the first day. If you look at Genesis, he didn't create the sun until after he created the plants. So
Okay.
that's
Look, maybe I have confused, but okay. Like, created the sun after he created plants. Like, isn't he the one that has the reason for it? Like, does he have to believe in science says, oh, it is this? Like, I don't know if you get me. Like, if he has the power to create such a thing, like, does he need the energy of the sun to power plants or something like that? Do you understand me?
I guess no. Yes, I understand you. I guess he wouldn't, but if he created everything, and by creating everything, he left traces that lead us to another conclusion. Wouldn't that be strange? Because
Okay, Jim,
what we find and what we can learn. Doesn't point to anything close to the Genesis account.
maybe most of what you read in science books are fake. Like, do you believe in evolution? You believe humans were once apes? Do you believe that?
I'll have to rephrase that. I don't believe it. I accept the science and I accept the evidence they have to back it up. And that's not something you believe. You can't choose to believe something. If there's evidence for something, then you can go
Okay,
and check out the
can I
evidence.
know, please, is the evidence was written in a book, right? The evidence is written in books, right?
No.
What is the evidence?
The evidence is found in studies about nature, and
Yes, and
by
studies,
observing.
men who wrote books.
No. It's not about the books, and it's not a.
It's just the same thing. No, you say you prove you like believe it's fact because like okay, there have been studies by human beings who made these things, but you also don't believe like the Bible because you can believe it's written by a human being. So what makes the like the observing what makes the observations that these scientists made to like what prove
Okay.
what makes it right like.
Okay. I can explain that. The theory of evolution is not based solely on what we observe. The observations we've made all over the years lead to what you would call a hypothesis. This hypothesis needs to be tested. Which means, if the initial idea is correct, it has to be able to have a predictive capability. So, if you know that, you can perform tests, but you can also extrapolate findings you should be making in the future. And a great example for that was that long before it was found, evolution predicted that a creature like, I don't know if you're familiar with that, with Tiktaalik, which is an intermediate form between fish and reptiles. It's
Okay.
basically a fish with legs, with gills and lungs, and through the fossil record, we could predict where this creature should be found. And when they started to dig in that particular place, they actually
Yes.
ended up finding fossils of a creature that fitted between fish and reptiles. And that's not the only one.
Okay.
We found a lot of evidence for that.
But
The same goes for
have you ever
humans.
come to your thinking that these fossils might have actually been planned to deceive the public? Like, do you actually think not like, okay, these fossils? Why is it like, don't normal average people find archaeologists or scientists like, oh, why can't I dig my backyard right now and see a fossil? Do you understand what I mean?
There
This
are
thing actually.
actually places where you can. I'm not quite sure where exactly, but at least you're in England, and one of the first dinosaurs was found in England. And if you like, I will try and find out where exactly, and if you're able, you can even visit that. They made
Yeah,
statues.
I've been to the museum in London.
Okay.
So, yeah. But my point is, these findings don't prove anything. And okay, I can actually put something like bones in my house and claim that okay, these are the bones of dinosaurs or something like that.
No, you can't.
So,
No, you can't.
I'm just saying no, I can't, but like if I had the money and the
No,
like
no.
capacity like most of these scientists have, I
No,
can do
no.
that and
Then,
everyone would leave me.
no, you still wouldn't be able to. And the reason why you wouldn't be able to is because you can't construct bones that are that old. We can determine how old the
Okay.
bones are. There are different ways to determine how old bones are. And
How, like how?
you can't reproduce those because you would never be able. Are you aware of a radiometric dating and how
No.
that works?
No.
Okay, I'm not a scientist. I just do this for a hobby, so I might be wrong, and I hope
Okay.
people will bash me if I tell you things that aren't true. I have a scientist who agreed to work with me and put questions like this, the answers to questions like this, on a website, and I'm working on that at the moment. But here's a quick way. All living animals take in nourishment. I think
Yes.
you would agree to that. Okay,
Yeah.
everything we take in the food we eat, there are certain elements that are radioactive. Now, those elements have half-lives, which means that over a period of time, the radiation will be half of what it was when you ate it. So as long as you keep eating, you will have the maximum amount of radiation in those elements. The moment you die, you don't take in nutrients anymore, so you don't get those elements in anymore. From that moment on, the radiation has a half-life over a period of time, and we can determine by looking at how strong the radiation is, how strong it still is radioactive. How long ago it was when this particular living being died. And that's how we determine how old something is, at least in living organisms. And
Okay.
so if
I
even if
understand
you had
that.
all the money of the world, you wouldn't be able to reproduce bones that would show
Okay.
up to be that old.
Okay, and this is my point. Like, what I understand what you just said, but like the machine used to take these things, why can't they be like, okay, why, I don't know how to put this, but they can actually be fake
No, they can't.
or made
No.
up
No,
to
they can't. And here's why. In the scientific community, you have something like peer review, which means that if you do a
Okay.
study and you note your findings, you publish that as a paper. Then it gets peer reviewed, which means every other scientist in the field is out to shoot your idea down, because if you make a good contribution, you would get famous. But if you are able to find fault in those conclusions, then at least the other scientist has a shot of being famous, because he already has your idea and he can reproduce the tests you did. So
Okay.
what you get in the scientific method is that once you found something, you publish it, and every scientist in the world that's able to is trying to poke holes in that. And if they can't, then it's going to be part of science.
Okay.
So there's a rigorous testing method.
Okay. I know I'm not really good in this field, but
Not neither am
there's
I,
something
so.
like I want to ask you. Okay, what do you think happens to people after they die?
They're dead.
So like
It's
nothing, no
the end.
afterlife, no reincarnation.
No. No.
Oh, okay.
For what we know now, what makes you and what makes me
Yeah.
is the mind, and the mind is a product of our brain. And when our brain dies, the mind dies as well. There's nothing that will stay alive after your body is dead. There's no evidence for
Actually,
that.
we have souls. We have souls, so after that, like,
Yes, but
after we
we
die, our souls either go to heaven or hell.
there's no evidence for souls either, and
Okay.
no one can tell us what a soul is,
Okay,
and
this is
we'll.
something I want to ask. You remember what I asked you on Twitter? Like, most atheists I see always put things like
Yes.
Satan or 666.
Yes.
If, like, atheist, I feel most atheists are anti-God, and like they know, like I don't know how to explain it. Like, why is it that they put things like that if they don't believe in?
I think it's just to either annoy or to ridicule, or maybe to attract attention. When I put this up, I will send you a link to my channel.
Okay.
I've made an intro for talks like this, and I have to at least admit it's not 100% friendly towards theists, because it kind of makes fun about things in the Bible. There's a reason why I did that, because for my part, I want to establish that atheists and theists can have a civil conversation. If you're on Twitter, and if you're on Twitter long enough as a theist and as an outspoken theist, you'll find that a lot of atheists aren't that friendly. And I think that's a big mistake, because I think we need to talk. And we at least need to exchange our views and do the utmost to make people think. And I think that if people are presented with the bare evidence, there's only one conclusion you can take,
Yeah.
and that is that so far there's no evidence for any God.
But should I tell you one evidence?
Please.
In the it says like, yes, it's hard to believe. It's in the book or it's in the Bible, like you can't see, like God won't show himself. You have to believe in him. That's the perfect way. Because, like, if he showed himself, you would believe, right? Won't you believe? Yes, that's the thing. So, if he showed himself to the whole wide world, like, he came to every door in the world and said, "Look, I'm real," like, everyone would believe. And, like, I don't know how to explain it, but, like, he wants you to have, like, the real faith. Nobody can prove he exists right now. You can only feel it
Okay,
and have faith and, like,
but
see from
there
what.
are verses in the Bible where God shows himself to people.
Yeah, do you know why? Because that was the old time. Now I feel it's like, okay, maybe now if he comes to someone, they can record it to the phone. But back then, like, there were no phones. So it's either you were there or you were not there. And if you read it, it's either you believe or not. I feel now like, okay, there's technology and stuff. So if he comes to someone, the person will record it. I don't know if you get me.
Yes, but
Yeah, so that's what I feel.
what would be against knowing, and why would we need faith? I think faith is the most unreliable path to truth. Wouldn't you agree? Because
Yeah, to be honest, like, thinking as a normal human being, you can say, okay, why faith? But, like, the person that created it knows the reason behind his, like, the vision and everything. All you have to do is believe. And the reason why I believe, again, is because, like, I've experienced the power of Jesus, like, millions of times in my life. Like, no, you wouldn't understand, like, and evil is actually out there. That's one thing I want to say. Like, if you look at the world right now, you see how many, like, disasters are happening, things happening. What would you say is behind that? Do you think it's evolution behind it?
No, it's not evolution. The evil as a force, I don't think exists.
So,
There
okay,
are
why do people do?
people doing bad things. There are things in nature happening that we consider bad things, but are just part of how nature works. And a storm, a
Okay,
hurricane,
but think
or
about it.
whatever.
If it was if it was like that, right? Why then no need for justice? Like, if it's just part of nature, right? Okay, if I murder someone, like,
Yeah, that's not part.
it's nature, no one cares about.
No, that's not part of nature. What evolution teaches us is that we came from monkeys. We have a common ancestor with the great apes. And what I think should at least make you proud is that we all came from Africa, because the earliest humans that were found, what we consider humans today, were found in Africa. So,
Okay.
and because
But
of
wait, didn't
because
Einstein
because be
say he
sorry, I couldn't hear that.
didn't say he be I said didn't Einstein say he believes, like, the world was created by someone or something?
Oh, you mean because of my avatar? I'll have to explain that. My avatar isn't because I worship Einstein in any way. I admire him for several reasons, and the first one would, of course, be because he was a genius, and he was ahead of his time. But what attracted me in Einstein was the way he always mocked people. He hated being famous. So if people came up to him and asked him, he always told them that he wasn't Einstein, and he acted as ridiculous as possible so people would think he was crazy. So that's my main part for having that avatar up there. But the question you asked, did he believe? No, Einstein was an atheist. He didn't believe in God. He left an
Yeah, and but I think he said something. I think he said something like, "Oh, from the way the world is finally tuned or something, something, there has to be a mastermind behind it."
No, he didn't. Einstein at first was seen as a follower of Spinoza, and he looked at everything in nature and in the universe that was his God. That's not a comparison to the biblical God or saying that the universe was the biblical God. To him, and in the period of time where he lived, that was a way of expressing yourself. To him, that was the greatest thing he could see. So, if anything should have the label of a god, it should be the universe and everything in it. And that's used a lot by theists, and they twist it a little and say Einstein believed in God, but he didn't. But my question is this: you think the Bible is the perfect word of God,
Yeah, it is.
and you believe everything in the Bible is correct?
Yeah, everything is correct. I believe that.
Okay, I have my main objection with the Bible could be a little sensitive to you,
Okay.
so I'm not saying this to offend you. I'm
No,
actually I'm
no
actually
offense. I
I'm
won't get to.
no no I'm actually saying this because I am offended by it, and that is that the Bible endorses slavery. And the slavery we had in
Pardon?
a couple of centuries ago was based on verses in the Bible. All the people that were taken from Africa and by Americans, but also by the Dutch, where I'm
Yeah.
part of, the Dutch were the worst in slavery. If slaves didn't behave, they were told, if you don't behave, we're going to sell you to the Dutch. So, but that was based on what the Bible teaches. The Bible teaches you can
Okay.
you can have slaves. And I think that if you have an omniscient, omnipotent, all-loving God, why would he endorse slavery?
Okay. I don't actually remember there's been slavery there, but okay. I think it's like this. Everyone has a role in life. People are meant to be poor, some rich, some will serve, and some will be served. So I think it's just a role. And to think about it, if like I feel if slave trade wasn't started, I'm not offended by it. I feel most of the things in the world right now won't be here because like the slaves really helped build the Western world. So like I feel there's a reason for it. Like God always allows everything. Therefore, like he knew, okay, yes, slavery will be there, but like it will benefit the world in the future. Because I felt now. Okay, it has made a lot of relationships with the Europe, America, and Africa.
But
So, yeah.
would you say it's okay to do that over the backs of maybe millions of people? To
And
condemn
actually,
them
I.
to a horrific life just to benefit another part of the world? Wouldn't that be unjust?
It can seem that way because there are a lot of things like I read in the Bible that like okay I feel like some type of way about it like how people get murdered and stuff like that but like God created the people so he knows what like their uses he knew why like they were born and it's sad it might seem sad but like some people will forever remain poor some people will like be born with disabilities and stuff like that but there's a reason behind it. Like, you and I can't really know. Only he knows, because, like, it's his design and plan.
Okay, but
So I just take it the way it is.
if people are born with disabilities, isn't that God's fault?
It's not his fault. He wanted it that way for a reason known to him alone. Not everyone can be perfect. Like, people are not the same. Most people were born like that way so others can help them, or so they can learn things about life and stuff like that. That's it.
I think that's very sad the way you think, because that means that you would glorify a being that can decide to torture maybe millions of people just for a reason he knows, but he's omnipotent. He doesn't need that. He could have made a world where everything was okay. He could have made a world where there was no evil.
Yeah, it's
But he
right.
didn't.
But let me tell you something, right? Okay, now I can kind of explain because it just came to me right now. When Adam and Eve, right? I'm sure you are familiar with this story. When they took the bite of the forbidden fruit, their eyes were open and sin came into the world. And
Okay.
everyone that is born into sin. It's because of sin, people get sick, things, illnesses.
Okay.
Because of sin, like, people do things. And this world is filled up with sin, and sin is evil, it's bad. So, like, when you are born into this world, you get that sin. So it
Okay,
might be like,
but here's the
okay, you come out with a disability or something like that.
but
It's
here's
just
the
because of the world we live in.
Okay, sorry, but here's the problem. I don't believe the story, but let's for now run with the story. Do you know what happened when Adam and Eve ate from the fruit? What actually happened to them?
Yeah, they thought, like, they became, their eyes got opened and they realized they were naked.
Yes, but actually the answer is in the name of the tree of the fruit they ate.
What fruit?
They ate from the fruit from the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
Yeah.
So by eating that, they gained the knowledge of good and evil.
Okay.
So that would mean that before they ate the fruit, they didn't have the knowledge of good and evil, so they couldn't decide what was good and what was bad. So
Okay.
they couldn't decide that if they ate from that fruit, that it would be bad. And
But
that is what's overlooked by most Christians. The one responsible
that's a nice point there.
The one
But let me tell you
respon
something,
No,
right?
I'm not
Listen,
fin
no,
Wait a minute.
I
I'm not
understand
finished.
what you mean.
I'm not
Okay.
finished. I'm not finished. The one responsible for original sin is God.
Okay.
He knowingly put the tree in there, and
Yeah.
he knowingly
Yes,
didn't
that's
give
exactly
Adam
what I
and
wanted to
Eve
tell you.
didn't give
Like,
Adam and Eve the concept of good and evil. If he
yeah.
had done
That's what I
that,
wanted to tell you. He knows what, like, even before it happened, like, even 5,000 years ago, he knew we'd have this conversation right now. So he knew, like, Adam and Eve were going to take it, and that was all part of his plan. Like, he wanted it to happen. Like,
but why?
I don't know, though, but, because
That
only
doesn't
he
point to an
knows.
all-loving
He
God.
wanted, maybe, what?
That doesn't point to an all-loving God. He as Genesis described, he made a perfect creation. And then
Yeah.
with the intent to screw up the perfect creation. And I wouldn't call that an all-loving God, would you?
Yes, I would, because he knows what he like. I, to be honest, we can have this conversation right now, and I won't know, 'cause like I don't know anything about that. I wasn't there, and I'm not like I'm just a normal human being, but like he knows the reason behind it all. So that's it.
Well,
I can't explain this one right now. Like, I don't know what to say, but That's the all I can say about this right now.
Okay. Well, what I would suggest is at least you go back and read the story and see if what I say is true, because
No, I know what you mean. I understand what you mean. Like, yeah, it's like he knew it was going to happen that way.
Yes. And that's not the
Exactly.
only time, because
So,
if you
okay,
believe
can
the
I ask you a
Bible,
question?
if you believe the Bible, he created everybody. But he created everybody the way they turned out to be.
Okay,
And
so like now, I think I understand something right now. You are not atheist because you don't believe in God. You are atheist because you are angry with him. Is
no,
that
no,
right?
no, 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 no. I have to explain that
Because
because
no, I
I was
understand. Like most people,
no,
like
no.
they claim atheism, but in they are really like angry with God.
No,
And like.
I'm not angry with God, because I cannot get angry with something I do not believe exists. That would be silly. I grew up as an atheist with atheist parents, atheist grandparents, in a completely atheist community, and the first time I really encountered religion was at the age of 21. And I was bombarded with religious conversations, with talking about the Bible, with listening to sermons, with listening to religious music for 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, and that for a period of a year. And we had some pretty good discussions with the guy who did that, which was my senior officer in the army. And after I got out of the army, I left it behind me and never considered it again until a couple of years ago, when I discovered creationism on YouTube. And that's where I started to worry, because now it's interfering with what I think is the most worrying. It's interfering with children, and it's interfering with their abilities to get ahead in life. It limits them. And that's
No,
where
it
I
actually
think,
doesn't.
yes, it
No,
does.
it actually enriches. Let me tell you something, right?
If
I
children
like
are withheld parts of
no.
science, I think it's limiting.
No,
Don't you?
like listen, no, I don't think so.
Why not?
'Cause like wait, limiting in what way? Like I went to school
I
so
can
and I
give you
studied science as well, like.
a perfectly good example. The most threatening
Okay.
disease to humans is cancer, right?
Yes.
Okay. The best cancer medicine we have today is based on the theory of evolution. That's the best working medicine we have. We also know that there are animals that never get cancer. We study those, and with that, we study the genetics, which are also another proof of evolution, to get to better medicine. Now, if you have children and you tell your children that evolution isn't true, they will never go and study that. But
No,
you might just help a child.
I actually
No,
studied that in high school.
listen to me make my point, and then you can react. You can actually make it so that that kid doesn't believe in evolution, but that kid might have the potential to find the cure to cancer. And that's why I think children shouldn't be limited, and children should know what is true. And if they want to believe in a God next to what is true, I'm fine with that. But don't teach them lies and don't teach them things we can actually prove are not true.
You know, you haven't actually proven to me that he doesn't exist, right? You are just bringing up scientific theories.
That's because I can never do that. I can never prove to you. I could never prove to you that something that hasn't proven to exist, I can never disprove that. Because no one has ever proven.
What would you say happens? Wait, what would you say happens? When people pray and something happens in that very spot. What happened there? Like, what was the cause of that?
I would say pure coincidence. And studies show that the effect of prayer is even less than what we would get by pure coincidence. It has been studied.
No, do you know, there's nothing like coincidence. We both said, he's omnipotent and omniscience. So, everything that happens is happened by his will, by God's will. So, there's nothing like coincidence. So, it's actually
study
the prayers for you his to will.
Say, to, for you to say that, you have to believe in a God, and I don't.
Okay.
There's no evidence for a God. And for most of the Bible, there is evidence that the stories in the Bible never happened. We for a fact know that Adam and Eve never happened. And we can
the fact that we came from Homo erectus or what?
Yes.
To be honest, that fact has never been proven to me. I've read through science books and I do not still believe that.
Okay, but it is backed up by paleontology, which is the study of fossils. It is backed up by genetics, our DNA.
We can
go back in our DNA and we can trace our DNA back to the other great apes.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Scientists do this. No one else. It can just be like a lie that
no,
it's
it
all in a scientific
no.
union.
No, it can't.
No, let me tell you, a scientific union led by the devil to fool and deceive people that God doesn't exist.
Okay, you know,
and that the devil doesn't exist.
You know, the leading biologist in evolution in the United States is a Christian.
And does she believe in evolution?
Yes, he's the leading.
Then she isn't a Christian.
Well, it's a he.
Okay, then he isn't a Christian.
Yes, of course he's a Christian.
If he believes in evolution, he doesn't believe in the word of God, meaning he isn't a Christian.
He has another interpretation of the Bible. That's all.
Yeah, that's a false guy.
Yes,
that's the thing. People come, they interpret things in the wrong way, and they fool people. Most people have been fooled in life, to be honest. That's the thing. I feel most people have been fooled, and people are getting fooled day by day,
yes,
each day.
But I think the same as you do, except I think people are fooled by an old book that has been proven wrong over and over again.
I ask you a question?
Sure.
It may seem like, I don't know, because I don't really know you like that, but it may seem... Don't take it the wrong way. I'm just asking to find out something.
Sure.
Would you say you have peace? Are you happy? Are you no matter what you have, do you feel like you're never complete at a time? Or do you feel okay, you have everything sorted out right now?
I don't have everything sorted out right now, but I'm happy with who I am, and I'm happy with the things I do. I think that I'm a compassionate human being. I care for other human beings. I care for animals. For instance, I've for all the time that I've been living on myself, I've had dogs, and except for one, I always had rejected dogs. So I once bought a puppy, and the rest are dogs. I were rescue dogs. The one I have now is actually was used as a puppy to train pit bulls. So she's covered in scars, is afraid of other dogs and aggressive towards other dogs, which I've been working for a couple of years to at least get her to not be afraid around other dogs. Same goes for
That's nice.
the same goes for humans. I've worked with less fortunate children. I've worked with children that are children of criminals, but also with children that were sexually abused. Children, I think you can Google that. In
Okay, that seems good, but
2000, we
there's just
had.
something I want to say. Like, there's one void, no matter it's in life. This is true, because I've like been in that situation. No matter how much someone gets in life, there's something that only God can fill. There's a void in the soul that only God can fill. Like, that's why most people, they get money, they have friends and everything, but like you see them, like they never get happy, because there's only one person that can really make you happy. And I've like experienced that in my life, because like for some time, like last year, I wasn't really happy. I was depressed, like being alone. But like when I accepted God, like everything changed. Like you can say, okay, maybe it's just faith in it, but like almost everyone that I've talked to that like has that believes in God has like said the same thing. Like
And here's
there's like if
and here's the
an
key thing. Here's the key thing. Everyone you asked that believes in God. I'm sure that if you were to ask the same question to people who don't believe in God, they don't miss that. Because I can't speak for you. I really can't, because I can never experience what you experience. But what I do know is that everything that you feel happens within your own body. And we can study, at least we can study the body. And when we do brain scans, and we do brain scans of people that can, in America, there are people that say they can invoke the Holy Spirit and speak in tongues. When those people do that, we can see where which part of the brain is activated, and it's not a part of the brain that deals with incoming external triggers. It's the part that deals with you personally. So we can actually show that people who say that at that moment the Holy Spirit takes over, it doesn't. It
Okay,
is
do you know
themselves.
why? Yeah, that's exactly. Yes, you have proven something. Because in the Bible it says like your body is the temple of God and like the Holy Spirit lives in you. So, okay, if it's in them, it means like it's the Holy Spirit that is in them that is working out. Do you understand me? So
Yes,
it's not coming like from somewhere,
but
it's
that's not
coming
what.
from their body.
Okay, but that's not what those people claim. Those people claim that an other entity is taking over, and we can show that that's not the fact. And we also can show that the patterns that we see then can also be achieved by drug use, certain drug use, where people hallucinate or get dreams. it shows the same pattern. So it doesn't show a different pattern,
So
and that's
you think it's just like in the mind?
it is in the mind. And
Wow.
that's what saddens me,
Okay.
because I listened to your music and I think what you made was it touched me. And the fact that
Thank
you
you.
give credit for that music to someone else but you, that saddens me, because it isn't someone else who made that music. It isn't. It might be that your environment inspires you to make music, but the one making the music is you, and you should get full credit for that. And by just saying it's a talent I got from God is where you give someone else the credit for things you actually do yourself.
Yeah,
You know
I
where I'm coming
understand.
from?
That's a very good, yeah, it's like
And that
it's a
saddens me.
logical explanation, but yeah, I understand you, but like I know like that I can't do this like 'cause I can freestyle 20 minutes on. But I know it's not my power. I know like it's a talent that was given to me. Like I didn't deserve it. Like 'cause I know not like everything I have right now I don't deserve, but it's given to me.
Why don't you deserve
And
it?
like when I
No, hold on, hold on.
because
Why don't
most
why wouldn't you deserve
because
it?
I'm full, yeah, because the thing is that we humans we fall short of the glory of God. We're always sinful, but like he's forgiving in that way that he gives
Let me
and he forgives
let
every time we
let
ask.
let me ask let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
Have you ever had the thought to hurt anyone just for the sake of hurting someone?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know, 'cause like it seemed fun at that time, like just to see what will happen, like
Okay,
why?
and now if you look back, would you say that was a good decision to make or a bad decision?
No, a bad one.
Why?
'Cause it's not right to do things against your neighbors, like we're meant to show love, peace,
And you know,
no non-violence.
okay, do you know where these feelings come from?
Yeah, comes from the book, the Bible.
No, they don't come from the book. We evolved as a social species, and because we there are other social species. It's not only humans. The great apes are social species, monkeys are social species, but dogs and wolves are social species. Elephants are
Are
social species.
dolphins?
Yes. And
Oh.
all those develop empathy towards their fellow species. And that is an evolutionary trait which took us from being a mere ape to the humans we are today.
Okay.
It's actually quite simple. If you hurt someone in your community, you hurt the community. And if you hurt the community, you hurt the species as a whole. So that's why it's wrong. And that's why I think that a secular morality is better than a religious morality, because a religious morality is just you following rules. And
No.
that's not.
Yeah, that's exactly the.
Yes, but that's not
Do you
the.
know one thing?
But that's not
It's
the
true.
fact, because.
Religion is all about following rules and not being yourself,
Okay.
not being free.
And if.
But let me
What
tell you
is.
something.
No,
I'm
no,
not
no,
yet
no,
done.
I'm
Wait,
not.
no. I know this is just a short sentence, but
Okay.
like having a relationship with Christ, with Jesus is not a religion. It's a like a real relationship like how you have with your dad or something like that. Like I wouldn't say I have a religion. No. I have a relationship with my creator.
Okay.
That's what I'll say.
So, and if this creator would come to you, let's say in a vision or in any way possible,
Yeah.
and tell you to kill your neighbor, would you do it?
Actually, yes, I would, because there's a story of that when Abraham
Now do
was
you
told to kill his son Isaac.
see why secular morality is better than religious morality? Because I wouldn't.
You wouldn't, cause like you don't believe. Okay,
I wouldn't because it would be wrong to kill someone.
but if the creator said, okay, kill the person, cause I know
Then it's
like
still wrong.
there's a reason for this.
No, then it's still wrong.
But he created the concept of good and wrong, so he knows what is wrong and what is not
He
wrong.
also supposedly
Did you
said
get me?
in the Ten Commandments, "Thou shalt not kill."
Yeah, he said that, so why would he come and tell me to kill someone like
Because
for
he,
no reason?
if you read the Bible, he's actually commanded that several times. It wasn't only Abraham.
During war, right? Like in war times.
No, not in
And
war,
let me
not
tell
in, not
you, that
in,
was the
no,
Old
no, 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 no,
Testament.
no, not in war times. Just
Testament. And
because other people had a different religion. They say that
yeah, that was
today.
the Old Testament. But
And
when
what?
Jesus came, he just preached about love and like.
So you're not a Christian, you're a Paulinian.
Pardon?
You're not a Christian, you're a Paulinian.
What does that mean?
You follow Paul, not Christ.
Nope, I follow Christ. Christ said we should love.
Christ said nothing of the
He's.
Old Testament is going to be abolished. Every single law will stand, not a jot or a tittle will be
Okay,
changed.
but why is it that
And now you say
we
the Old
don't do
Testament.
lamb sacrifices again? We don't do lamb sacrifices.
Because most Christians aren't Christians. They follow Paul, not Christ, not Christ.
Nah.
You can look it up.
Okay, what
And
was your name again? Sorry.
also, Christ told you that if you do not hate your father, your mother, your brother, and your sister, you can't be a follower of Christ.
He didn't say you should not hate. He said if you love them more than you love me.
No.
He never said hate,
He
'cause
literally,
Jesus never said anything ab about hate.
it's literally in the
He
Bible.
only preached about love.
No.
What?
There you're wrong. There you're wrong.
He said hate.
He said hate. I can.
Nah. Never said that.
I'll pull up the verse for you so
Okay.
you can read it. Luke 14:26.
Okay.
And
I'll read it after. Luke 14:26.
yes, I can at least read you part of that. If anyone comes to
Okay.
me and does not hate father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even their own life, such a person cannot be my disciple. And I don't know what Bible version you use.
What one is that here?
I didn't catch that.
What version? What version is that?
What version do you use?
I use NIV.
NIV.
Yeah.
I'll see if I can find the NIV.
Okay, so like I wanted to tell you, I said in the next couple of years, that thing you listen to, you'll see what God will do for, like in my life with the talent He gave to me.
Yes, and
And I hope then you'll realize that.
let me tell you, you make yourself think that, but actually it's you who's doing it. And
Nah, it's not really
you,
me.
yes, it is. And I think that a lot of people who call themselves Christian, or at least are convinced they are Christian, are using this as a method to get ahead in life, which actually wouldn't be that bad, but it wouldn't be real. And
But okay,
I
if
think
it wasn't real, so why would it work?
everything you do comes from you. You contacted me today on Twitter,
Yeah.
which actually was you asking a legitimate question. I took that opportunity to have a talk. And I actually thought you were from America, and I'm thrilled that you're from Africa because I had a chance. I talked to a girl, and I'm not sure where she was from, but I think she might also have been from Nigeria. A brief talk, and a very good talk, actually, until she browsed my timeline, and at the moment I was fighting with someone who called himself Christian, but was, in my opinion, even too vile to be called a Christian.
Yeah, that's the
And
thing.
she bumped
Most people.
into that call, and based on that interaction, she terminated the call and blocked me on Twitter. She has since unblocked me, and we have spoken again. But I think that, and I think you might even agree with that, that education is still lacking in Africa, and that is par at least partially the Western countries are responsible for that. And that's why religion plays a bigger role in that part of the world. And that sadly also goes for the United States, where education isn't that great either. And you said you were in England, you study there. Can I ask what you study?
Law.
You want to keep that out of the conversation.
Pardon?
You want to keep that out of the conversation.
No, I said I study law. Law.
You study law. Oh, sorry.
Law. Yeah.
I didn't catch that. You study law. Okay,
Yeah.
I think while you have the opportunity, you should check out some claims science makes, because you're in a position to at least check out if there's any truth behind it. And also
Yeah, I would.
also check
Like,
out if it's true that some of the claims in the Bible, that we have evidence that it never happened, because genetics tells us there's such a thing as a population bottleneck, which means an absolute minimum of individuals present to keep a species alive, and that has never plummeted below 10,000. So if we know that, and we can actually see that in our
Okay,
in
but do you know that it says in the Bible people lived up to 1,000 years? Do you know that?
Sorry, you cut out. I didn't get that.
Yeah, I said, do you know, like, it says people in the Bible, like in the olden days, lived up to 1,000 years. So I understand what you mean about the population, but if they could live that long, do you get me?
Yes. So why didn't we?
It would definitely increase.
Okay, but why haven't we ever found human remains that were that old?
That is exactly what I am saying, that these scientists may be lying about those things,
Why
those remains.
would they lie? What would be a good reason to
Yes,
lie?
that's exactly it, because the devil doesn't want people to actually be saved. He wants them to burn in hell with him.
Okay, but
And like, as long as you don't believe God exists, sadly, there might be no heaven for the person.
and
So I just hope you like realize soon
okay,
that
but
God actually exists,
here's a
and
question. Here's a question. What you're claiming now is that tens of thousands of scientists all over the world
have been deceived.
in countries that actually disagree with each other and fight each other, there is some kind of pact that keeps those scientists together, and no one
Yeah,
and no one
it's possible.
and no one is getting the secret out.
Okay, no, it might sound weird, but it's actually possible. Like, why do
It's
you think it's
impossible.
not? 'Cause
It's
isn't it
impossible.
only the top scientists that bring out theories? Like, the scientists in my school never like brought up any theories or anything like that.
What do you mean they didn't put up any theories?
Like the ones in my school, they never like discovered anything, any new genetic what is it called, evolution stuff, something like that. It's only the ones that are like the top ones around the developed countries that produce all these things. That's what I mean. So
I don't
it's
agree because when it comes to human lineage in evolution, Africa is the base of human civilization.
Yeah,
So
that's yeah, but who found those, who found those fossils?
every
Who
discovery
found the fossils?
the
Wasn't it either
No,
Americans,
no, no, no.
British?
The latest fossils, not that long ago, was a species which are now called Homo naledi. They were found by Africans.
Which Africans? South.
I'm not sure in which country it was,
Okay.
but. It's not true that these findings are just made by Western countries. That's nonsense.
Okay.
That's
Okay, let us
that.
forget. There's no pact. But like I said, actually, the devil doesn't want people to know he exists. That's the truth. And like, I feel you are a good person. Like, you sound like a good person, and I'll actually like you to research more. And I hope one day you actually find the truth.
I actually have. I read the Bible a couple of times, and
Yeah,
I
but I
read it
hope.
cover to cover,
Okay, can
and
I ask you to do something, to do me a favor?
sure.
If you are like, if you don't really believe in this, I know it might seem stupid or awkward, or you might not even do it, but okay, one, like, just these days come. Just be asking, just say this, like, Jesus, if you exist, show yourself to me. That's all. Like, if it like or doesn't show, you have your right to continue to believe what you want. But definitely I know he will
I
show.
actually have done that in the past.
And he never came.
He never came.
What? You've
And
done that.
yes.
Okay, and what happened?
I had a girlfriend for a very brief period of time, and she asked me to do that, and I really wanted it at that time to be true. But
Okay, I
here's
understand.
the thing. I take pride in being honest.
But wait,
And
did you really have faith it will happen or were you just doing it like, I don't understand. Did you just do it for the sake of her?
at that time, I think that she was at least an influence. But at the time, things weren't going that well for me either. So, if there would have been an easy, what I think an easy way out, I would have taken it. But I take pride in being honest. The fact that you called. I've got Skype on one laptop. At the time that we spoke, I was rendering a call with an atheist who pretended to be a Christian. He set up a fake Twitter account, he set up a fake website, and
Why did he do that?
just to ridicule Christians to make them look more stupid, I guess. And I knew he was an atheist when I started the call, but I ended up doing a call about an hour with him before exposing him. And I did that to at least let him make the most ridiculous statements. And within minutes after our call, his Twitter account was deleted, but his website was as well. So I take pride in honesty, and I'm honest towards you, but I'm also honest towards myself. And if I have to believe something, which for me doesn't mean just believe because I want to believe it, I have to accept it, and there has to be evidence to back it up. And that's where the Bible fails on all counts. And as we progress now and learn to find out more and more, we already know the city of Bethlehem didn't exist at the time of Jesus' birth. That's been
How do you know that?
because there it there are, have been digs there, and they can find artifacts from a time
What if it's not called?
before Christ, and they find artifacts of a time after, but not during. And that's a significant thing to have, because at the time of Jesus' birth, it was just a burial place. And now they are researching actually the life of Jesus, and more evidence comes up that Jesus might never have existed. There might have been a person called Jesus, but the Jesus as described in the Bible never existed, because there is no contemporary there are no contemporary writings of Jesus during his life. Everything you have
Okay,
stems
and how
from
are you sure?
stems from
Why are
from
you?
at least 30 to 40 years after he died.
Yes, exactly. So, what if that's the whole idea? Like, let me tell you something. I'm sure you are familiar with this John 3:16. Do you know that verse?
No, I can look at.
Okay, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son,
Yes.
that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life." The word you have to underline there is believe.
Yes.
Why was that word there? Because God obviously knew it would be impossible for
No,
people to believe that something like that happened. No,
I
let
think
me just explain
yes.
my point. So, like, he knew that, okay, it's going to be hard for people to believe this thing happened. Like, it doesn't really seem, but like, once you just get that out of your mind and you believe, like, it's just, you just see. I don't know how to explain it, but I just know that
Why
reason.
would you choose to believe something for which there's no evidence?
Because I have seen the evidence in my life. Like, I can't even start telling you all the things that have happened to me because
Okay,
of God.
name your best.
My
What would
best.
you what would you be your
My
best?
life. My life right now.
And what do you mean?
The
You have to be
gift of life.
the gift
The
of
gift of life.
the gift of life. You owe that to your
Yeah.
parents.
Nah, I owe that to God.
No.
'Cause people die every day and I'm always protected.
Oh,
And
you're not always protected, and it's sad. I've been following what's happening in Britain, and I wouldn't say you're completely
Okay.
safe in Britain at the moment.
Let me say something.
It would
Yeah, I'm not completely safe, but he said something that 1,000 may fall at my side and 10,000 on my right hand side, but they won't come near me. So things may be happening around me, but I know for one that I'm obviously safe and like nothing can come near me. That's it.
I think there's always the possibility you could die in a car accident tomorrow,
Yeah,
or
it's possible, but that kind of thing can never happen to me because I know who is protecting me. He said like he won't even let my foot to hit the stone, let alone die in a car accident.
so what you're saying is that no Christian can have an accident?
No, they
I
can't.
think that's quite easy to disprove.
No, I know, I didn't say like it did not happen. But okay, if there's a reason, like maybe he wants them to go home on time, like go back to heaven. If not, if they live longer, they will fall into sin or something like that. If it's like he has a reason, but if
So
it's not yet my time for any disaster and I can't die.
if you can find or make up a reason for that people, for those people to shorten their lives, then it's okay. Because it isn't.
It isn't okay, but people die every day in
Yes,
different
people
ways.
die every day. There are children dying of cancer. There
Yeah,
are
but I know
parents
that
dying
I
of
have to
cancer,
fulfill.
but there
Yeah, but.
are an equal amount of Christians dying of cancer than there are of other religions or atheists. The number is the same.
Yeah, but just let me just tell you something, right? A lot of people claim to be Christians, but they are not really Christians. For example, Donald Trump. He claims to be, but he isn't executing the word of Jesus. Now, that's what fools a lot of people, why people run away from Christianity, because people live in a false way that isn't the right way.
I think we agree on that. If, and I would go even further, that if reincarnation was real, then we could be witnessing the reincarnation of Hitler. But that's my opinion of Donald Trump.
Yeah, same.
He's a fake. He's a con man, and he'll do.
I feel
He'll.
something bad is about to happen because of him.
It's already happening. It's already happening. We have a white supremacist in the White House who just took over the National Security Council. So
Okay, sorry, like tomorrow I have uni, so I need to get to bed right now. But please do that, try and do that thing I asked you to do. I know you said you've done it before, but there's no harm in just trying. Like, just do you know what I mean?
Yes, I know what you mean.
Yeah, like
Well,
it would be nice if you tried it.
at least I think I could do that. What I would like for you is to would it be okay if I sent you a link to a YouTube video about evolution?
Yeah, you can.
Would you watch that?
If it's not too long, I would.
Okay, I'll try to find something that's at least accurate, but not too long, and I'll send it to you.
Yeah.
And then I
Okay.
hope that you can come up with a topic for a second talk,
Yeah.
and maybe prepare for that talk, so have some questions ready you want to ask. I've done a couple of talks like this, so I never prepare. I pretty much wait for what people have to. I can't prepare if I don't know what you are going to say, so I have to go in unprepared. But if there are questions you want to ask me, feel free to ask me in the next call, and I'd like to at least thank you for accepting my offer to a talk and to record it and to make it public, because I think talks like this could be important to some people. And
Yeah.
I hope it makes you think about the things I told you.
And I hope it also makes you think, although I know you don't want to think about anything about that.
It's my
You've
main
made up your mind not to ever
No,
think
no, no.
about it. And that's the problem.
It's my main topic on Twitter, and I'm still open for evidence. If someone comes to me with
But let me just
hard
tell you something,
evidence,
right? If you are looking, no, wait, let me tell you this. I know what you're looking for, but if you are looking for hard proof, just know you'll never find it. That's all I can tell you. If you are looking for someone to show you, oh, this is real proof, trust me, you'll never find it. But just open your mind and your heart, and you'll see what will happen to you.
okay, you claiming that.
Yeah. I'm
Why
not
would
claiming
you?
it. It's true.
Why? Okay, I almost agree because I can't rule it out that someone comes with hard proof, but I almost agree. But why would you believe anything for which there is no proof?
That's the gift of faith. You have to have faith.
I would call it the curse of faith because it limits you.
Nah, actually,
It
you know, faith actually says
limits
you
you.
can move a mountain, so you can actually do anything with faith. You are actually one of the
The
most
verse
powerful when you have that.
you are referring to is actually one of the verses I use to prove to people that Jesus lied.
How did he lie? Because he said, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can move a mountain.
Yes.
That can actually be a figure of speech, to be honest.
Have you?
You know, like,
No. It's
how figure, it might be a
in
figure
that
of
no in
speech, it
that
might be
verse
real.
in that verse is it's not meant as a figure of speech, and you can go back to the verse.
No, I know the verse you're talking of, but I'm just saying it can be a figure of speech. It might not be, but it's actually true, because if you say, okay, I want you to move there, you don't know what can happen. It might be excavated and moved by the contractors or something. It's just,
Then it's
I don't know how to explain it,
not you moving the mountain, right?
but it's you if you had the
No,
faith, right?
it's not you. If it's moved by contractors, it's not you moving the mountain. It's not Jesus moving the mountain, it's contractors moving the mountain.
But it is him moving them to move it,
No,
right? Since he does everything.
there's another reason. There's no contractor in the world that would go move a mountain just for the sake of moving a mountain. No one would do that. There's a reason behind it.
Was okay. Thank you.
So please, I'll consider what you said. I hope you consider what I told you. And
Yeah.
I'm actually looking forward to having another talk. And I want to thank you for this one.
Thank you.
I will at least leave a link in the description to your music on SoundCloud, because I think
Oh, okay, yeah. Thanks,
that's
man.
worth sharing. I thought it was good, and I've been a DJ for several years. I had my own radio show, I had my own TV show, so I think I at least earned the right to say something about good music. And this is good music, and if it gets out, I think a lot of people would like it, and I think you would have no problem at all selling music like that because it's good.
Thank you.
Okay.
And I have no problem at all, because I have the one who gave me the gift by my side.
I think you are the one that developed that gift. And you should get full credit for it. That's the difference between you and me.
Anyways, have a good night.
Okay, you as well. Thank you very much, Osi, for contacting me and for agreeing to do this talk. And
Okay, thank you.
okay,
Bye.
take care. Bye bye.